Hi everyone, welcome back to Guido. Today we will show you how to replace the LCD screen assembly on the Redmi K20 series aka Xiaomi Mi90 series mobile phones. To start, we need the right tools to proceed with the repair, which you can find in the description. First, turn off the phone and take out the back cover. To remove the back cover, we are using a heating pad. Place the backer side on the heating pad and select the mobile phone heating option and leave it till it completes. Alternatively, you can use a heat gun or hairdryer around the back cover edges. Once you feel the heating is enough, use a suction cup to lift the back cover. In between, insert a plastic car pry tool and gently cut the adhesive. Next, remove the back cover and remove the board frame by undoing 12 screws. Next, disconnect the battery connector. Next, take out the logic board by disconnecting 4 connector plugs, the antenna head and undoing the board screw. Make sure to release the front camera connector adhesive. Gently lift the board using a tweezer while moving cables aside. Next, release the screw on the front camera motor. Next, gently pull out the front camera through the opening while lifting the motor. Next, apply heat and pull out the front camera motor from the board. Next, add some heat to release the sensor flex and earpiece from the body. Next, take out both power and volume rubber brackets from the frame. Next, gently pry and pull out the power and volume flex cable from the frame. Next, take out the bottom cover by undoing 8 screws. Next, take out the LCD flex by disconnecting the connector. While pulling out, gently release the adhesive from the connector. Next, disconnect the main connector and touch ID camera from the charging port board. Next, gently grab the adhesive and release the LCD connector from the charging board. Next, take out the SIM tray. Next, release the antenna from the frame. Next, pull out the charging port board from the body. Next, apply some heat and pull out the touch ID camera from the body. Next, gently pry and pull out the vibrator motor from the body. Next, take out the battery. First, loosen the adhesive on the sides and then pull it from the tab. Be gentle and lift the battery. Next, move the battery protective tape to the right hand side and then gently pry the main cable from the body. Now, the only remaining part is a broken front screen assembly with the frame. For the replacement, there are two different screen types are available. The one is with the frame and the other one is without the frame. It can be original, used, refurbished or aftermarket. Either version you choose, you can get with the frame and without. But the most straightforward repair will be with the frame. And also the price difference is not that big. I recommend you go with the screen with the frame installed. It can be original, refurbished, used or aftermarket. And this type is commonly available to purchase. Next, on the new screen frame, start placing removed parts. First, place the button flex on the frame and then secure both rubber brackets. Next, place and secure the sensor flex and earpiece. Next, insert the front camera through the opening. Next, place the front camera motor and secure the screw. Next, place and secure the logic board. Next, secure the logic board by adding the screw. Next, fold the cable and secure the front camera connector to the board. And also place the adhesive. Next, place and secure the vibrator motor in the frame. Next, secure the Touch ID camera. Next, place the charging port board in the frame. Next, insert the SIM tray. Next, secure the main ribbon connector from both ends. Next, secure the antenna in the frame. Next, place and secure the battery with adhesive. Next, secure the LCD cable from both ends. Next, place and secure the speaker cover by adding 8 screws. Next, secure the main flex, the antenna head and battery connector into the board. Next, secure the board frame by adding 12 screws. Next, before closing the device, it is good to verify the functionality by powering up the device. Next, before installing the main back cover, ensure it has enough glue. If not, use B7000 glue or new double-sided backer adhesive. Finally, we are adding binding clips to tie in the rear car with the body. If not, you can use some rubber bands and leave them for some time. Hope you have enjoyed the replacement guide. Let us know if you have any questions. Please like, share and comment on our videos. Hit the subscribe button for more videos.